Hello guys, in this video I'm going to explain image filtering low pass and high pass in frequency domain, the MATLAB program. Due to some circumstances I'll not be able to explain it on MATLAB as my laptop is not working, but I'll try my best to make you understand each and every line that is written over here. Let's get started. This is CLC clear all close all basics. Now A is equal to IM read cameraman.tif. So there will be this cameraman image that will be loaded in variable A. So and now when you take IM read, so this is basically a uint 8 variable. So this is uint 8 variable. So it will have values 1, 2, 3, 255, 100 like this. They will range from 0 to 255 and they will be all integers. There will be no floating points over here. There will be no 0.5, 0.3, nothing. So this will be uint 8. But now we have to do it in frequency domain. Hence it is necessary that we'll have to take FFT. Now whenever we take FFT, we know that we will get one that is complex values and other we will get in point. Here in FFT, the frequency domain, point is very important. So hence first what we'll have to do is we'll have to convert A into IM to double. Now let me tell you what is IM to double. So basically IM to double is this range from 0 to 255 will be converted to 0 to 1. How this happens is basically you multiply by 1 by 255. So whatever the image is over here, when you multiply this by 1 by 255, so this will become 1 by 255. So that will be some 0.0, 0.0 something, something. So basically you will get a range that lies from 0 to 1, where 0 by 255 will be 0 and the maximum element 255 is 255 upon 255, so that will become 1. So this is what IM to double does. It converts the image from 0 to 255 to 0 to 1. So this is what IM to double does. And we know that when we do IM show, when we do IM show of a double variable type, if we do IM show of uint 8, it treats 0 as black and 255 as white. But if we do IM show of double variable, IM show, then it will take 0 as black and 1 as white. And the range between this, say 0.5, will be gray, absolute gray. So this is the difference between IM to double and normal double operation. Normal double operation will just convert the data type from uint 8 to double, but it will not change the values inside. Whereas IM to double will convert the uint 8 to double data type. Also, it will change the values. The values will be range from 0 to 1. So why did we do this? We did this because we had this FFT operation which requires 0 point, the integer point is very important for that. So hence we converted into IM to double. Next, what we'll do is we'll take the FFT. So whenever we take the FFT, I am denoting it with capital A. So capital A will have complex values over here, and what this will look like if you do IM show of this, what it will look like is something like this. It will have white values. This shaded region denotes white color, and the middle thing will be black. So it will have basically all the information at the corners. Now to process such kind of image is very difficult. So instead of this, what we do is we shift. We basically multiply minus 1 raised to x by x plus y. So what is x plus y is the pixel value over there. Suppose this is the first row and the first column, so x and y will be 1, 1, etc. So when you do a shift, so basically the function for that is FFT shift. Also remember, here we are doing two-dimensional FFT. FFT along the rows, FFT along the rows, and FFT along the column. So hence we use the function FFT2. Next we'll have to shift. So when you do FFT2, this is the image that we get, but we want a symmetry. Not symmetry, basically we want the data to come at the center. So for that we use FFT shift. So when you do FFT shift, the data comes in the center. Next, what we want is, now this will have all complex values, so we want to deal with real values. Hence what we do is we take the absolute value. So absolute value, that is basically the modulus. So there is a function abs. So when you take abs of a shift, you will get real values, and the image will look almost the same. It will also have white values in the middle and black values around it. Now what we actually want to do, now we want low pass and high pass image filtering. So here, if I take a mask, basically these values, these data that is inside this, which is along the center, these white values, these denote the low pass image. The low pass image are always over here, and the values that are outside, that denote the high pass image. So basically what we want to do is, if we want low pass image, we will take this portion. We will basically take a circle over here. We will take a circle, outer circle. This will be input defined. So basically user defined. The user will tell the value of the radius of the circle. So we will take this circle. Whatever inside it is low pass value, whatever outside it is high pass value. So if suppose this circle is D0, suppose the radius of the circle is D0, anything below D0, that is in this below D0, that is anything that is less than D0, let it be X. So X is less than D0 will come over here. Anything that is greater than D0 will come over here. So that is the low pass and high pass thing. So whenever low pass, you will have D0 less than X. Whenever high pass, you will have D0 greater than X. So let us see how we will implement this in MATLAB. So we had our matrix over here, that is A shift matrix, and we did AABS of that. So we took the absolute value of here. Here we have A shift, we took the absolute value of A shift, and we got this matrix. Now this is ABS. Now whatever operation that we will perform, low pass, high pass, that we will perform on ABS. So what is the basic concept is, let us zoom this ABS a little bit. So we will take the size of ABS first. In M1 and N1, we took the size of ABS. D0 is an input. D0 will it will take a number basically, and it will ask you to enter the cutoff frequency. So it will take a number. I'll tell you where it is used. So we took M1 and N1, that is the size of ABS over here. So ABS will be M1 rows, N1 columns. So the center pixel of ABS will be M1 by 2 and N1 by 2, the center pixel over here. Now what we want to do is, basically we need distance of every other pixel from the center. Distance of every other pixel from the center. Now suppose every other pixel is denoted by I, comma j. Suppose this point over here, let me denote this point as some pixel value I, comma j. So this is the ith row and this is the jth column, like that. So the distance between this pixel will be given by the distance formula. So the distance formula is nothing but square root of I minus M1 by 2, I minus M1 by 2, that is x minus x1 by x minus x1 the whole square. So I minus M1 the whole square plus j minus N1 by 2 the whole square, y minus y1 the whole square. So like that. So this is the distance formula. Using this formula, what we are doing is, we are creating a distance matrix. So what I have done over here is, this is a for loop, I going from 1 to m, j going from 1 to n, I 1 to m, j 1 to n, and distance dij. So there will be this distance matrix that will be formed over here, which will be equal to square root of I minus M1 by 2 the whole square plus J minus N1 by 2 the whole square. So this is the distance matrix that will get formed. And if suppose this distance is less than d0, now let me take a simple example. Suppose d0 is 2. So this is the matrix. So now you can see at center, when you are at center, I will become m1 by 2, j will become n1 by 2, because you are at center. So it is basically a point, the distance is 0. So this will be 0, hence the center distance will be 0. Then as you move, you will get 1 distance, then over here root 2, and the story. So basically now what you have to do is, now d0 is a number that will be input by the user. That is what you have told as cutoff frequency. So now d0, if suppose d0 is 2, so what will happen is, this is the distance matrix. So what it is considering, if d of I comma j is less than d0, so that will happen in this area. Here d of I comma j will always be less than 2. So here it is 2, here it is root 2, here there will be some value. So like this you get a circle. So this is exactly similar that we want. We want a circle, and if we low pass, then we will take all low values, that is any all values that are inside the circle, and if it is high pass, then we will take the outside values. So hence for low pass, what we'll do is, if d of I comma j is less than d0, if d of I comma j, this d of I comma j, whatever values will come over here, so every value is denoted by d of I comma j. If this value is less than d0, d0 is our constant circle, then you take that value as it is. So I am denoting a new matrix B. In this B, I will have the low pass image stored. So in this B, I will have the same value as ABS. So because I want to retain all the values that are in the circle, and I don't want any values that is outside the circle. So any value that is inside, I will take it as it is. We are always taking from ABS, so that will be same as ABS. Else, if suppose this is not the case, then means that the value is outside. Then take that value as 0. We don't want any values that are over here. Then take that value 0. This is the main logic of this code. Once you have done this, now you just have to end. This end is for if, this end is for this for, and then end for this for. Then what you have to do, B is equal to FFT shift. Once you had shift over here, so it is very necessary to shift it back. Now you are in frequency domain, you have to return back to the time domain. So once you had shift over here, so again you have to shift. Then you will take IFFT2. So this is two dimensional inverse Fourier transform. So IFFT2 of B. In B you have this image. Then you take FFT shift of B, you take IFFT2 of B. And then now this will also be complex, because Fourier transform always gives you, DFT always gives you complex values. So hence you take the modulus of that. So you will get B2. So now this is the main thing, the main gist of the program. Now whatever is asked to you, you can take IM show. So if original image is asked, then you will take IM show of A. If suppose what we say, if A shift image, before shift, after shift is asked, then you will, if before shift is asked, then you will take capital A, after shift A shift, then absolute value. So whatever is asked, you can take the IM show. Also remember, in this program we will not convert the values of IM show to uint8, because we have all values in point and they are for a purpose, because we have taken FFT shift. So in this program every value will be in double, every this variable will be in double. In IM show also you will keep the variable as double, you will not convert any variable in uint8. That is the main significance of this program, because we have used FFT, which has a lot of significance to points, and uint8 does not consider any point, so that is very important. Also here I've done low pass. If you want to do high pass, just change the sign. Just by changing this sign, you will get the high pass image. That's it. And you follow all these steps again, so you will get the high pass image. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you understood. If any doubts, you can put them in the comments below. I will surely answer it. Thank you.